I would say that one of the most important trends is national governments taking more responsibility for and also asserting greater control over humanitarian response. As a related trend, I think we're seeing an increasing fragmentation of international humanitarian response in terms of a proliferation of smaller organizations coming onto the scene in addition to the larger, more established humanitarian agencies. And this, I think, is contributing to a trend of some disagreement, discussion over what actually is the scope of so-called principled humanitarian response as opposed to other forms of relief and development aid. I would say at the same time, however, we're seeing a trend towards calls for reaffirmation of the core values of humanitarian aid. So not just in relation to clarifying outwardly to the public and donors, but also internally within the humanitarian sector. I think a very strong trend in terms of increasing calls for professionalization of the humanitarian sector. This is a new trend and certainly rapidly growing. And the calls for professionalization, I think we see coming from all levels. So from affected people, from governments and major donors, and also from professionals themselves working within the sector. I would recall again what we were looking at in terms of the major trends. So taking first the trend of national governments taking more responsibility as well as a strengthening of the regional dimension, I'd say there are significant opportunities in this area, of course, towards being able to build true resilience and preparedness in the most vulnerable parts of the world in terms of natural disaster. But there are also, of course, challenges associated, particularly in terms of ensuring that governments in different parts of the world will still in the future accept and are appropriately able to manage international assistance when that's needed and when offered in accordance with humanitarian principles. Then looking at the issue of proliferation of smaller organizations or what I'd call the fragmentation of response, there are some challenges here, I think, that we're already starting to see and will likely increase in terms of accountability, coordination, also the professionalism of response and lack of connection in many cases of smaller organizations to established coordination structures and, of course, proper staff support. Looking at the issue of professionalization and increased mobility of staff, there are huge opportunities here in terms of newfound possibilities for really focusing on the level of the individual professional when thinking about the professionalism and accountability of humanitarian response and a greater possibility to really reach a truly professional and more efficient and accountable response. Challenges, of course, it's more difficult to offer the needed staff support when we have most organizations currently not being able to invest in learning and development of their own staff. I'd say in the area of technology, particularly information and communication technology, again, a major trend and a challenge in this realm is that connected with the increasing spread of ICT around the world, it increases the complexity of needs. So in a disaster response situation, people don't only require shelter, food, water, sanitation, they also require electricity to charge their cell phones to be able to keep updated to receive information. So I think it's changing needs, but also on the other hand, creating opportunities for improved and lower cost communication of the response infrastructure, improved information gathering and analysis, needs assessment. I'd say one very important point, international NGOs headquartered in Africa, Asia, and South America, these organizations will become stronger, larger, and more involved in sector-wide policy discussion and coordination. I'd say along the same lines, the major Muslim charities, foundations, and donors will become more integrated into the larger humanitarian sector. And then looking at human resource issues, I think the picture of the sector will be an even lower percentage of staff in northern headquarters locations, and also a lower percentage of international staff in response situations. So we'll see a greater responsibility of national individual responders, either as national staff of international organizations or as national organizations. I think the humanitarian sector will have a greater proportion of technical experts. So if we're looking at the staff within the sector, a greater proportion of technical experts as opposed to generalists. But this will mean that there will also have to be a system in place for ensuring that these technical experts, often coming from other sectors, have the opportunity to gain the requisite core knowledge and skills to be able to work effectively in humanitarian response contexts. I would see the Sphere project playing a role liaising with other relevant technical standard setting bodies. So in the existing areas that Sphere is looking at, but I would also see Sphere potentially expanding into other areas, logistics, telecommunication, where there is work happening in other parts of the sector and where Sphere can play a liaising and coordinating role in a sense to ensure that relevant minimum standards are aligned across the technical areas. Second point, I would see Sphere playing an important role in terms of promoting consistency in the use of key terminology and concepts related to humanitarian action at the institutional level. So using its position and role as bringing together some of these major NGOs, using that position to assist with coordination and consistency of use of concepts at the institutional level.